and welcome.
You invited me to the show and how dare someone else present it? You look delicious for my soup. Step into my cauldron.
Oh no, Bawega!
Welcome to... what is this hideous show called?
Flags and Foods! Flags and Foods!
Whatever. New day, new place, I can't tell all that. Привет! Mr. Flag, where are you?
Baba Yaga, may I ask the three quirky questions? Today, we again have a region within a country. So the first clue is going to be about the country and the next two clues is going to be about the region. The region is where Baba Yaga is actually from. Clue number one. The capital of this country is home to the most billionaires anywhere else in the world. The last count was around about 78. Clue number two. This region is infamous for gulags, the forced labor camps set up in the 1930s all the way up to the 1950s. Clue number three. This region is associated with cold weather. In fact, the coldest temperature recorded in any inhabited land was here in a town called Omikyon. Kindergartners in this region undertake what is called dowsing, which is they run outside into the freezing cold in their swimwear and pour freezing cold water over themselves to acclimatize to the cold and for building their immunity. The country is Russia. And the region is Siberia. I visited Siberia in 2018. Siberia is the biggest region in Russia and is absolutely massive and measures around 13.1 million square kilometers. To put that into perspective, that's equal to 77% of Russia and larger than the second biggest country in the world, Canada. Siberian region offers spectacular and diverse scenery and is steeped in Russian myth and folklore. Siberia top 5 attractions. 1. Lake Baikal. The most famous landmark of Siberia, UNESCO World Heritage listed Lake Baikal, is truly a specialist in superlatives, the deepest and oldest lake and largest freshwater lake in the world. It holds the world's 20% of the freshwater reserves and it represents the unspoiled beauty of Russia. Smoked omul fish is a speciality of Lake Baikal. 2. Altai Mountains. It stretches for 2000 kilometers and is located at the territory of four countries: Russia, Kazakhstan, Mongolia and China. The highest point of Altai is Belyukha Mountains at 4,506 meters and it's significant as it's located at the exact geographical center of four oceans. In Altai Mountains, you can see almost all the natural zones of Russia: steppe, forest steppe, taiga and the mountains. 3. Puttorana Plateau. Another UNESCO World Heritage listed site, Puttorana Plateau is also known as a land of 10,000 lakes and 1,000 waterfalls. There is no place in Russia with such a concentrated quantity of waterfalls. Located on the remote far north of Siberia, visiting Puttorana is like walking into another planet. Lake Vivi, also known as the geographic center of Russia, is also found here. 4. Yergaki National Park. Located at the western Sayan Mountains, Yergaki National Park offers a diverse scenery packed into a compact area and is a perfect gateway to the pristine nature and is a haven for both summer and winter activities. 5. Tomsk. Siberian towns are famous for its wooden architecture and the creme de la creme of this Siberian Baroque style of architecture can be found in Tomsk. The prime attractions are Tomsk State University, the house with the firebirds and the patterned casings of the windows.
Today, we are preparing
You still haven't introduced me properly.
Sure, Baba Yaga. Siberia is a land steeped in mythical folklore, of which the most prominent one is Baba Yaga. Baba Yaga is a witch that travels in a bucket instead of a broom, and she lives deep in the forest in a hut which stands on magical chicken legs. Baba Yaga is known to abduct, cook and eat her victims, mostly children. Parents use various stories of Baba Yaga to keep their children disciplined.
And nowadays, Baba Yaga is undergoing an image makeover and being rebranded as a Russian superhero.
You're making fun of me now? I am a witch, not a superhero.
Today, we are preparing pelmeni, known as the heart of the Russian cuisine, and the origins are traced around the Urals and Siberia. Pelmeni are dumplings which were historically made using horse meat, but nowadays they are made using beef or any other mince.
The ingredients for pelmeni are 2.5 cup flour plus extra to dust, 180 ml warm water, 1 egg, 500 gram minced beef, 1 garlic crushed, 1 onion finely chopped or ground, salt, 1/2 teaspoon pepper. Combine the meat, onion, garlic, pepper and salt. Mix well and keep aside. For the dough, combine flour and salt. Mix in the egg. Add water slowly. Knead for about 5 minutes to form the dough. Roll out and flatten the dough with a rolling pin. Cut out small circles from the dough. Fill with meat, fold over and pinch the edges together to obtain the typical pelmeni shape. Another method is to use a dumpling mold. Here, we place 1/2 of the flattened dough on the mold, fill the meat mix in each cavity and cover with the other 1/2 of the dough. Use the rolling pin to lightly press and separate the pelmeni. Then flip the mold over and gently push the pelmeni out. To cook, boil water in a large pot and add salt. Drop in the pelmeni and cook for about 8 minutes. The pelmeni are cooked when they float to the top. Smear a little butter on the pelmeni and relish them with a side of sour cream.
Hello, Junior Food.
Hello, Mr. Flag.
The two questions. Question number one. There are two animals in this region which is very famous and which has a name Siberia before it. Can you name the two animals?
Is it Siberian polar bear and Siberian penguin?
There's nothing called a Siberian polar bear or penguins. One of them is the biggest tiger in the world. It's called a Siberian tiger. And the second one is one of the cutest animals, the Siberian husky.
Oh, husky! Their puppies are so adorable.
Yes, they are. Question number two. There is a very famous person from Siberia who has been part of one song. The song is by Bonnie M.
I don't know who that is.
I will give you a humming of the tone where his name comes. La 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 la.
I know that song!
What is it?
Rara Rasputin. I don't remember that.
Lover of the Russian Queen.
Lover of the Russian Queen.
It's actually Grigory Rasputin. Now let's have the food.
I heard food. Is the junior food soup ready?
No, Baba Yaga. We have got something more delicious for you today.
It better be good.
Thank you. Since Baba Yaga is our chief guest today, she will be giving the verdict.
Actually, this tastes better than the children's soup. So I will give a double thumbs up.
Thank you, Baba Yaga. Junior Food should be very relieved now. At the end of the day, a dumpling is a dumpling is a dumpling. It's so relishing. And this one has hit all the right spots. The only difference between the different kinds of dumpling is basically the seasoning and the meat used. One of the most amazing experiences while in this region, I would call it a bucket list item, a once in a lifetime experience, is to travel on the Trans-Siberian Rail Network. Now, the Trans-Siberian is the longest rail network in the world. It starts in Moscow and goes all the way up to the Russian Far East, to the port town of Vladivostok. It covers a distance of around about 9,200 kilometers and it is spread across 8 time zones. It's virtually a time machine. There are 18 stations on this route and the train only stops around about 20 minutes on each station. So this is basically a gargantuan rail journey. There are also two inter-country versions of this. One is from Moscow to Beijing, called the Trans-Manchurian. And the next is from Moscow to Ulaanbaatar in Mongolia, called the Trans-Mongolia. Traveling on the Trans-Siberia is an experience of Russia in the miniature. Starting from a huge city like Moscow, passing through various industrial towns, to the vast wilderness of Siberia, and to the Pacific coast of Russia. I did a sampler route from Yekaterinburg, which is the capital of the Urals region, somewhere in the middle of Russia, to Irkutsk, the most popular town in Siberia. The journey was about for 3 days. Trans-Siberian is also a great opportunity to meet other Russians. It's sort of like an annual pilgrimage for most Russians. They want to take the Trans-Siberian rail line at least once. So we could see families of Russians traveling together. I was booked in a 4-coupe compartment and I had a Russian family there. But the language was a huge barrier. On the 3 days, we hardly spoke to each other. We just had the curtsy smiles. But there's one area where all the non-Russians congregate. The pantry cars. And we also had our rondo. Every time the 20-minute break comes in the stations, we all get out of our compartments and say our curtsy hi. There are two different distinct experiences. One is traveling on the Trans-Siberian in summer. And then traveling on the Trans-Siberian in winter. Now, I opted for the summer one to see more of the scenery. But if you want to see snow everywhere, go for the winter option. It was a bit of a tiring journey to be stuck in a compartment with people who don't speak the same language. But I'm really glad that I could do that huge tick off my bucket list. Travel on the Trans-Siberian.
Spasibo viewers for tuning into Foods, Flags, whatever. If you liked me, better subscribe to this show or I will find you and eat you.
Don't forget to press the bell icon.
They will be back next week with some cooking. Keep your travel nightmares alive.